Hello and welcome to my seventh lecture, where we'll be studying about insert, delete, and formatting the Excel rows, columns, and the cells. Okay, so we will know over here how to insert rows, columns, and delete. We will also know how to delete the worksheets, how to add the worksheets, and lastly, we'll come to know how we can protect the Excel sheet. Okay, so I'll just share my screen and we'll show the Excel sheet over here. So this is the sheet which we have been referring, and this is the sheet that we have referred in the last lecture as well for explaining conditional formatting. Okay, so insert, delete, and format section is here in the cells command prompt. Okay, we'll just look what contains under insert, delete, and format. For in the insert section, we have insert cells, rows, columns, insert sheets. Delete cells, rows, column, sheet, format, how to change the row width, column width, hide and unhide, okay, how we can rename the sheet, tab color, you can change the tab color, and lastly, you can protect the sheet, okay? Now, say for example, I want to add a column between Amrita Haldar and Mehul Kumar, okay? So I'll go over here, we'll select it like this, or I'll use a shortcut. What's the shortcut? Shift. Space, okay, shift space for row and control space for column, right? So I do this, I'll go over here, I'll select insert sheet rows. Oops, this is done, sheet rows, this is done. So I have added sheets after going into the insert tab. Okay, now say for example, I want to add a column, I'll go over here, insert sheet columns are getting added now. How do you add the worksheets? These are called worksheets, okay? These are called worksheets. This is a workbook and these are worksheets. There will be times where you would need to add worksheets. So either you can click over here into this plus sign, or you can go onto insert tab, click on insert sheet, insert added, right? Again, another, again, see, another, right? So this is insert new sheet. Okay, this is how new sheets are added. Now let's get on to the delete sections, right? The same, select the row by clicking shift space, go to delete cells. Even if you select delete cells or delete sheet row, it will delete this row, the selected row, delete sheet rows, delete rows, delete rows. If you want to delete the column, go over here, delete sheet columns, and the shortcut for this is control minus, right? Again, the shortcut for deleting a row is also the same, shift space, control minus, right? I'll just undo this. Now if say for, you want to delete the sheet, I won't delete this sheet, I'll go over here, I'll click on delete sheet, sheet one is gone. Insert new sheet. You see the name over here, insert new sheet. This will be gone now, delete sheet. Now I want to do this with a shortcut, Alt H for delete. I'll go to D for select deleting a sheet. I'll click on S. So Alt H D S, Alt H D S, Alt H D S, right? And suppose I want to insert the sheet. See, D is for delete, I is for insert. So Alt H D for delete, S for sheet, right? Now Alt H I for insert, S for sheet. Alt H I S, I for insert, S for sheet. Alt H D S, D for delete, S for sheet. Alt H D S. Done. These are common Excel shortcuts which are required while working, right? It will make the process faster. Okay. I'll take you to the new worksheet. I'll explain the format section over here only. Suppose I'm writing Nabind Kumar. Okay. I do wrap text already explained. I want the row height. See, this is 40, right? Say for example, I want to change this row height 20. Oops, Nabind is gone. Where it is? It is here only, but we can't see because of less size. Either you can go and resize it like this, or you can go to format, row height, click on 35. This is done. Now I'll just enlarge it a bit. Oops, data is copied. I need to enlarge it. This is enlarged, right? Now if you go and check the row height, it is 96, okay? I want to auto-fit it. like whatever text it is, it just needs to autofit itself. Oops, autofit is done. Okay, now for the colon, this is the same. I'll go to format, I'll click on colon weight, I will do 78. Oh, this is done as well, right? Format is done, autofit, the same thing. Just click over here, go autofit. This is done, right? Now, what's the shortcut for this? Like say, for example, I'll go Alt H O, and for colon width, autofit colon width, it is I, right? For row, let's see, for row, Alt H O for format, and autofit height, A, Alt H O A. Right, so this has auto fitted the row. Alt HY auto fits the column. These are the shortcuts. If you want to hide and hide, let's go over here again to understand hide and unhide. Say for example, I want to hide the June data. So how do I do this? I'll go over here, hide rows. All the rows are hidden, right? I'll go again, hide sheet, unhide rows. Say for example, I want to hide this column. No. If I just select this, I go over here, hide columns, the colon is hidden, right? Again, I go over here, the colon is hidden. Now, say for example, I'm here, new worksheet S1, I want to hide the sheet, I'll click on hide sheet, the sheets are hidden. Now I want to unhide the sheet, I'll go over here, unhide columns, the columns are unhidden. Now I want to unhide the sheet, unhide sheet, new work S1, it has come over here, click on OK, right? So this is now unhide. Now you want to rename the sheet. How do you do this? Pretty simple, go and double click, just rename it. Like say, for example, Nabil, it's renamed, or you can go over here, click on rename, and then you can just rename it, study box. This is pretty simple, pretty easy. Okay, now tab color, if you want to color the tab, you can go to a format, tab color, you can just color this, the study box is color this one. Okay, now the important part comes over here, which is a protect sheet. How do you want, how you can protect the sheet, like password protected, how you make the sheet password protected. Okay, I'll just save the work, I'll go over here, I'll click on protect sheet. I'll type a password, say for example, NABIND, Nabind. Again, I'll re-enter the password. Okay, this is done. Now what I'll do, I'll just close this Excel sheet, okay? Save, I've just closed this. Again, I'll come and open this sheet again. Now let's see what happens. This is password protected, remember. Since it is password protected, everything gets unchecked instead of this format, right? You go. Now, if I want to enter something, what it says, the cells or chart you are trying to change is on a protected sheet. To make a change, unprotect the sheet, you might be requested to enter a password. But to do any entry, go over here, click on unprotected sheet, type in the password, and this is how it gets unprotected. So here in this section, we have learned how to insert sheet, rows, columns, how to delete sheet rows, columns, how to format the row height, width, and how to protect the Excel sheet. So these are the things that we have learned. Please practice the shortcuts, especially because this will make you faster when it comes to Excel. The faster way is the easiest way because it consumes less time. Okay, so practice more and more. In the next section and in the coming 5 to 7 sections or 10 sections, I'll be dealing with Excel formulas. So please stay tuned, because whatever is coming, like the Excel formula, these are very, very, very important. We'll first learn the basic formulas and then we'll learn the advanced formula as well. Stay tuned, and as always, be educated and change the world. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Bye.